We are ready. So, hello, Makla.
Hi, Auntie.
Hi. How are you?
We are fine.
Very good. So, today I'm going to teach you something very important. Tell me the names of the girls who are there, girls and boys.
Only girls, Auntie.
Only girls. Okay. Who are the girls? Shilpa, hi.
Shilpa. Hi.
Soumya. Swarna, hi.
Hi.
And who's next to Swarna?
Mata.
Huh?
Mamata.
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 You girls are growing up. Okay, shall we start the class? Yeah? So I'm going to teach you something today. Before the camera turns, I'll tell you what we are going to make. Today we are going to make sambar powder. We make sambar, but we should know how the sambar powder is made. Yeah? Would you like to learn sambar powder? Oh, very good. You can even do business afterwards. You can make sambar powder, put your label, Swarna sambar powder, and sell it. Yeah? Okay. This is my masala box. All of you girls go to English medium school, isn't it?
Yes, Auntie.
Yes. Good. So I will speak in English only, okay? Because I am more comfortable in English. And you know English, okay? So, this is my masala box. Can you see my masala box?
Yes, Auntie.
Yeah. So, this is a masala box and I have so many things in it. And these are all called herbs and spices. And we will start with what we have in the center. You know what this is? Turmeric powder. Excellent. Very smart. Turmeric powder. And you know what this is? English algotilva?
Uh-huh.
Okay, it is called mustard in English. Mustard. Okay? Sasivege. Mustard antare. You should learn these things, okay, now. English medium high school girls should know all these things now. So this is mustard. And what is this?
Jeera.
Jeera. Very good. Do you know the English name for jeera? It is called cumin. Cumin, C-U-M-I-N, cumin. Okay. Then we have, you know what this is? Try.
Dhania.
Yes, dhania. Dhania seeds are called coriander. Then the next we have here is?
Pepper.
Very good, black pepper. That's nice. And then we have, what is this? Idu menthya. Menthya is also called methi in Hindi, and in English it is called fenugreek. Fenugreek. Okay? You try to remember these words. If you can't remember, then we will do one exercise today. We will try to write down all this in the language you know, and then we'll look up a translation online. Okay? Okay, you ask Sulochana aunty to look up for the English name of these spices, okay? Okay, that's your homework. Along with the recipe, you have to write down the recipe. So these are spices and herbs in my masala. Now, we also have, India is very, very, very fond of chilies. No? We like spicy food. Khara, we want khara, isn't it?
Yes,
everybody wants spicy. Khara means spicy, and these are chilies. These are called bergi chilies. Have you heard of bergi?
Yes, Auntie.
Yes, you would have heard of bergi. Bergi is grown in our state. There is a place called bergi. They grow these chilies there. They're very long chilies. They have very good taste, flavor, and they have a very beautiful red color when we cook with it. So we are going to use many of these ingredients with the chili and some curry leaves. I plucked them from my garden before we started. This plant has come from Caronia manei. Shall we go in the kitchen and make the powder? Sambar puri. Yes?
Yes, auntie.
Let's go. So this is my kitchen. So here I have a wok. Bandli antarala. Bandlige, English alli, wok antare. W-O-K, wok. Okay? There's a flame going under this wok. So it could have some moisture. So we have to roast it lightly, gently, and drive away the moisture. Once the moisture is gone, the seeds will become very crisp and it will give a great aroma. Aroma means? Aroma andre? Suvasane. Suvasane. Huh? Aroma. So you can't say smell. Smell is for anything. Dirty smell, good smell, all smell. But aroma is always used for a very good, pleasant, appetizing smell. Okay? So now we are going to make sambar powder. And for the sambar powder, I'm going to first take some dhania seeds. You see dhania?
Okay.
And our dhania will form the main portion of this powder. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let's say 4 spoons. This is a tablespoon. Tablespoon. You have a teaspoon, which is smaller than this, and you have a tablespoon that is this. It is a standard spoon anywhere in the world. So if anybody says tablespoon, you should read. You get these in the market. And there is a marking over here that says TBSP, which means it's a tablespoon. So I have used how many tablespoons for dhania?
4 spoons.
Very good. Now, because all the spices have different weight and texture and they are different and they don't roast at the same time. So we have to roast them one by one because we want our powder to be perfect. So now my flame is on very low, medium to low. See, medium to low. And I'm going to roast these seeds a bit. Why I'm touching it is because I want to feel how hot the seeds are. You don't try this at home. Don't try it in the beginning. When you become a good cook, then you can do all this circus, okay? So now we can already start. We already smell the dhania. It's a great aroma. Gammantai de vasne. Very nice. In your kitchen, your Chandri aunty makes big sambar, no? Buckets of sambar powder. Am I right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Do you know? She makes a lot of sambar powder. But you please come and check. Check the seeds.
It's like a dark color, right, though, Alva?
Now it's enough. Now it's nicely roasted. So we will take it off. And we will add it to the dhania seeds. Okay? And then we will use jeera or cumin. So I put 1 spoon of cumin, 1 tablespoon of cumin, and we'll quickly give it a roast. So now the cumin is ready. Now we put it in this. Did you see the wok is very, very hot? When you cook, you have to be very careful. Otherwise, you will get tattoos like me. 1 tattoo here, some tattoos here. Because I'm very bad in the kitchen. I keep touching everything hot. So now we're going to put in some pepper. And we'll go again. Pepper will happen very fast. It doesn't need too much heating. Very quick pepper. Quick. And we are done. And we will add it here. Next. So remember what I have added because I'm going to ask you, okay? 1 tablespoon of mustard seed. Mustard andre nimge barlilalla hesru English alli mustard is called mustard andre
sasive.
So ig hakidini ig nodi neevu yen hakidivi nalak bhaga
men
ha what is this
men
nalak bhaga
dhanya
one bhaga cumin
cumin
one bhaga
cumin
fenugreek fenugreek menthya one bhaga
mustard
one bhaga
mustard
idu
pepper
very good so ivagella gothaytha aid ingredients hakidivi iga baradu most important chilies ha chilies illa andre ee ipati bisliruttala so hot you can dry it in the sun nicely for 3-4 hours and the chili will become very crisp and dry then you don't have to put it in the wok okay so you must plan the day you are going to make sambar powder if it's a hot day you put your chilies out at 10 o'clock in the morning and bring them in by 2 o'clock and then you can start roasting your other spices okay you understood
yes auntie
so if you have any doubts you can stop me and you can ask me I like questions and I like to answer them okay okay so the chilies are nice now they have become nice and crisp so I'm going to take out the chilies and look how colorful our sambar powder ingredients look they look so nice no together look so beautiful one last thing I have and I like to put curry leaves these curry leaves are dried they are dried they are washed first always wash your curry leaves never use anything green that is not washed so I wash them and then I put them under the fan on the table to dry them now when I roast them they will become crisp and nice it will take a little longer time selva jaasti time tagolutte idu ha will take little longer in the meanwhile can you tell me what sambar you had today for lunch
yaar kadai
rice curd rice so you see the leaves how dry they are I've turned off the flame I've put off the flame no more flame because it's very hot and you see the leaves see can you hear they have become crisp yes they have become crisp so now I'm going to put this also on top of this right looks so pretty no we are going to blend it mixie nalli haaki idanna pudi martivi naavu iga okay
okay
okay I'll just break the chilies because they are so big so I'll just break them You must be sure that your blender is very dry. You cannot use wet grinder for this, okay? When you make a powder, you must make sure that your blender is very dry. You put it in the sun and any water that is in the blade or under the blade will evaporate in the sun. Gotaita nan helido?
Ha gotu aunty.
Why did we roast the spices to dry out the moisture alla tegiyakke okay now if you put the chilies first in your blender and you blend it just break down the chilies then the powder it's easier to powder otherwise the chilies keep running the whole chili will keep running inside so I've broken it and I will just run it pulse andre just start and stop okay I broken the chili ivag idella olaga hartine ella olaga hartine ee first class sambar pudi madana ha ig nodi don't have to make it very very fine. ಪೌಡರ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ ನೋಡಿ ನೋಡಿ ಹೇಗಾಯ್ತು ಎಷ್ಟು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಇದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಹಾಕಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡಿ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್ ಪುಡಿ ನೋಡಿ
ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರಾಚ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರಾಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಿದರು ಯಾವುದು ಅಂಗಡಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಈ ಪೌಡರ್ ಕೊಡು ಆ ಪೌಡರ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿರೋ Shall we sit there on the table and they will tell us?
Okay.
Okay, come. So now tell me, how did we start? What did we put to make the sambar powder? One by one, tell me from the beginning.
Dhaniya seeds.
First?
Dhaniya seeds.
Dhania, how much dhania we put?
Four tablespoons.
Tablespoons. Yeah, we put four tablespoons. You can put four teaspoons. You can put four anything, any measure, any cup, any measure you want. Four of it, four portions. So we'll say four portions of dhania. Then next one, second one.
Menthya.
How many portions?
One portion.
Yes. Then third one?
Jeera.
One portion. Then?
Mustard.
Mustard, one portion. And?
Pepper.
Black pepper portion. Okay. And then what did we put? Two more things on the side next week.
Chilli.
Yes, we put chili. We put badgi chili. We put. You can also mix guntur and badgi. If you like too much khara, you can put some guntur because guntur is very khara, very spicy. So you can put some guntur and some badgi. It will be spicy and it will be colorful and tasty. So sometimes we do that, but we don't like very spicy. So we put only badgi. And then
curry leaves.
Did I put any oil?
No.
Did I put any water?
No.
Driving the water out, right? So now all the seeds are dry. Then what did we do?
Grinder
or a blender or a mixy. Okay, you can say anything, but usually people call it a blender. When you put two things together and you mix it nicely, you are blending so that everything mixes very nicely. Okay, so you can call it a blender or a grinder. It's a dry grinder. That what you saw, my blender was a dry one. So always keep the dry one separate for your masalas. If you make chutney one day and then you use the same thing for grinder, something wet will remain under the blades. So it is screwed on inside, you know, it is screwed. The blades are screwed. So some moisture can be inside and it can spoil your powder. And somebody this side ran away. Why? Who is there? Mamta. Where are you? I miss you when I don't see you.
I'm using.
Okay, good. That's fine. Okay, so then we put the chilies in first, right? I broke the chilies and then we ran the blender. And we broke it a little bit. What did we do? We pulsed it. You saw the pulse.
Yes, sir.
With your machine. All most machines have pulse. So you pulse the chilies. And then you add all the other roasted spices and herbs. Okay? Herbs and spices. You must use these terms. Spices and red. So khara irodakke spice antare. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಹರ್ಬ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಖಾರ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅದು ನಾವು ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಗೆ ಕಷಾಯಕ್ಕೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಸೊ ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹರ್ಬ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಹರ್ಬ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಚರ್ ದಟ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸ್ ಪೌಡರ್ಸ್ ನಾವ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟೂಡ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೌಡರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಓನ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರೆಸಿಪಿ ಬುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಾರೋನಿಯ ಮನೆ Every class writes their recipe. You have to write the name of the recipe and you have to write first the ingredients. Ingredients andre samagri. You have to write in English, please. I want to see the right words. You must use the right words. Because after you go, there will be other children. They will see that recipe they want to make, or you can copy it and you can keep it in your home. When you grow big, when you have your own house, like Anu auntie, you will be cooking in the kitchen. Then you will call Anu auntie and you will make sambar for Anu auntie. Yeah? You invite me, no? To your house. Okay, kids, did you enjoy this class?
Yes, auntie.
Okay, we'll do more classes. Do you want more classes?
Yes, auntie.
Okay, we'll do. Now, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye,
auntie.
Bye, love you. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.